Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Mike Garrity. In Commitment 2012 news, a News 9 exclusive on Donald Trump. The real estate mogul is scheduled to come to the Granite State in June. The visit was confirmed by WMURPoliticalScoop.com. Trump will speak to business leaders at the popular Politics and Eggs series. The trip will coincide with the timetable that Trump has set for making a decision on whether to run for president. Cleanup efforts are underway at Hampton Beach today, trying to clean up all those plastic discs that have been washing ashore for days now. The discs are from a wastewater treatment plant in Hooksett, and they are showing up in Massachusetts now, too. Crews spent the weekend cleaning Plum Island, Salisbury Beach, and beaches in Newburyport. Officials say hundreds of thousands of them ended up in the Merrimack River after heavy rains caused tanks at the plant in Hooksett to overflow a week ago. The discs have tested positive for E. coli. DES says the disc system at the water plant is very new. It was only installed in November, they say, and officials did not really know what would happen with all the heavy rain. A man accused of beating a 3-year-old Rochester boy with a belt is making his first court appearance today. 45-year-old Thomas Goodwin Jr. was arrested Saturday night. He faces 3 charges, including second-degree assault. Police also arrested 36-year-old Heather Tibbetts and charged her with falsifying evidence. Investigators say she's accused of hiding the child during the investigation. The little boy was treated at a local hospital and released. The U.S. Department of Energy is holding a public hearing tonight on the proposed Northern Pass project. It's the first of several hearings scheduled on the controversial plan, which would bring a high-powered hydroelectric power line from Canada through New Hampshire. Several towns across the North Country have passed non-binding resolutions against the project. Today's hearing is set for 6 p.m. at Pembroke Academy. Spring officially starts this coming weekend, but there are already some sure signs across the Granite State. Take a look. This is what Lake Winnipesaukee looks like in Meredith today. You can see the ice melting away. It's a similar scene in Laconia. Even further away from the shore, the ice is thinning, and that means a growing risk for anyone or anything still on the ice. In fact, by law, state law that is, all bob houses have to be off the lakes by April 1st. Firefighters urge caution, especially this time of year.
In the middle of the lake, there may be plenty of ice, but in areas where there are things that conduct heat, the ice will be much thinner. Things that include, objects frozen in the ice, bob houses, man-made structures like docks and boathouses.
Safety officials remind people that ice conditions change quickly. Ice that seems solid one day could be dangerously thin the next day. Well, some of the biggest names in rock music getting a big honor today. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland is welcoming new members. The 26th annual ceremony will honor musicians like Neil Diamond and Alice Cooper. Tonight's ceremony is set to take place at the Waldorf Astoria Hotel in New York City. And to help get you ready, we have a special slideshow right here on our website of some of the best bands and solo artists who are not in the Hall of Fame. You'll find that in the entertainment section right here on WMUR.com. And starting tonight at 5, more on the contamination of waterways in New Hampshire and Massachusetts after thousands of small discs poured out of that Hooksett water treatment facility and are now littering the shores of beaches, what state officials are saying about how it happened, and the cleanup. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.